Hi guys, you're watching Explanator and today's video is all about pure resistor connected across an AC supply. Voltage, current, power equations, phasor diagrams and finally graphical representation of the power consumed in a purely resistive circuit. Let's get started. To begin with, consider a pure resistor connected across an AC supply. The alternating voltage is denoted by equation V equals Vm sine of omega t. Because the circuit is closed, there will be a flow of current in the circuit. Let the magnitude of current be I. Our first task is to find out the equation for this current. According to Ohm's law, V equals I into R. Rearranging the terms, we get I equals V divided by R. Substituting the equation for voltage, we get I equals Vm sine of omega t divided by R. The value of current will be maximum when sine of omega t equals 1. Hence, value of Im, that is maximum current, will be Vm divided by R. Therefore, the equation for current will be I equals Im sine of omega t. It can be seen from the equations that voltage and current are in phase for a pure resistor. To draw the phasor diagram, consider voltage as the reference. And since there is no phase difference between the current and voltage, current phasor will follow the same line as that of the voltage. The magnitude may vary depending upon the numeric value. Now that we have the equations for voltage and current, let us calculate the power dissipated in the circuit. Power is given by voltage multiplied by current. Substituting the values, we get P equals Vm Im sine square omega t, which when reduced further equates to P equals Vm Im into 1 minus cos of 2 omega t upon 2. Now that we know the equation for power, let's plot the curve. Consider a xy plane with omega t, that is the angular frequency, on x-axis. Draw a table to plot the voltage and current waves. Mark the values of omega t on x-axis, voltage and current on y-axis. Tabulate the plot for different values of omega t, that is in this case 0, pi by 2, pi, 3 pi by 2 and 2 pi, and draw the corresponding plot. Next, to plot the power plot on the same plane, tabulate the values for the power equation. You will observe that during calculations, the value for power does not go negative for any value of omega t, because in the negative half, as voltage and current are both negative, their resultant multiplication turns out to be positive. The power consumed in a circuit is classified into two types. First is instantaneous power and second is average power. Instantaneous is what is consumed at the moment, while average is taken over the entire working cycle. The equation which we have derived was for instantaneous. Upon expanding that equation, we'll get two terms. The first term, that is Vm Im by 2, is constant, and the second term is variable as it contains omega t. For average power, take the equation for instantaneous power and integrate it over the cycle 0 to 2 pi with respect to d omega t, and then divide it by the total time period, which is 2 pi. The first integral will give a value of Vm Im by 2, while the second term, which has cosine in it, will return 0. So the net average power becomes Vm Im by 2. It can further be written as Vm by root 2 into Im by root 2, which is popularly known as Vrms multiplied by Irms. Moving over to the graph, the plot which we have drawn is for instantaneous power. The average power is constant and of the magnitude Vm Im divided by 2. For power curve in terms of RMS quantities, plot Vrms and Irms. product of VRMS and IRMS is the average power. If you evaluate the area under the curve Vm Im by 2 and that under the sinusoidal curve VRMS into IRMS, it will turn out to be just the same. The power plot is always positive except for 0, pi and 2 pi when it drops to 0 momentarily. Positive power means that voltage source is constantly delivering power to the circuit and it is consumed by the circuit. So that's how you plot a waveform for power consumed in a purely resistive circuit. Do let me know if you have any suggestions in the comment section below. Like, share and subscribe to never miss an update from Explanator, where every solution has a simple explanation.